here. Okay, so we have a bowl. Duh. We have regular long grain rice. Don't pay attention to that. So we have rice. Sirloin. I always use ground beef sirloin.
It's from Walmart.
Doesn't matter where you get it.
I know, I'm just saying
this
from Walmart.
From Walmart. Yeah. Right now, I only have one egg. I'm not sure if I'll be adding another one until I get the meat in there and I look at it. Okay? And then Hillary was so kind enough to cut up my vegetables.
I'll have to add more.
She's going to have to cut up some more carrots because there's not enough. Lots of celery and lots of cabbage. Muy bueno. All right. I would usually put cilantro in it, but I don't have any cilantro. So we're just gonna make it the generic way. So I'll probably see a little bit more than that. So as soon as I put the rice in, I'll know if I'm gonna need another egg. And then we're gonna use two eggs. This is going in the freezer, so pop.
And she used broth. It's already seasoned with my mom's homemade seasonings and garlic. Go.
Okay, so now I'm gonna put the rice. I usually put half a cup. But that doesn't look like it's enough, so I'm gonna put another not full cup. Who knows? I may put more. This is my homemade seasoning. It says garlic, but obviously it's not. And I'm not gonna say what I put in here because that's what makes it mine. Usually I put, like I said, I'll put cilantro, but I don't have any. And then I'll put a little bit of salt. Like half a teaspoon. Because it really doesn't need it because of my homemade seasonings, which has no salt, but it has other stuff. So now I have two eggs. And that's only because I have extra rice and a little bit of extra
meat.
Okay, my hands are clean. I just washed them. So we're gonna get in here and we're gonna get dirty. Okay.
So your mom's gonna think you're a nut.
Sure, he knows. So we're gonna move it around. We're gonna beat it up.
Careful.
Hit it like it's your ex-husband. Aggression. This is where the aggression, this is where you let it out. So yeah. I know you feel me, Mom.
So I don't think she would want to do that. It'd turn into pancakes or mush.
Right? So it does look a little eggy, but that's okay. Because the egg keeps it together. And I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit more rice because there's so much meat. So you could pause it. So we ended up putting a little bit more, just like a hair over a full cup. But I usually put a little bit more because I like it to be full of rice. This way the rice saturates the soup also. But I'm just gonna leave it right there for now. And then we're gonna just make our balls. That sounded funny, right? So we just roll them nice and tight. Sorry, Mom. Hillary's cochina today.
No,
so we'll move it over here. Since the stove is over here. Lower the fire, please.
Yes, ma'am.
So we got the broth going little by little. And then we just... Sometimes I'm lazy and I only do just like a couple rolls. But they stay pretty intact. Next one I'll let you look at. So I don't like them really big. I like them bite size. There you go. See? Nice and tight, and it'll stay like that. So this will be finished in about 20 minutes after I'm done rolling them, depending on how many balls I get. So I'll show you what it looks like after I am done. Okay, Mom. So here's the meatballs after we finish putting them all in. See how strong? What a strong balls they are. They're not going to fall apart. So all we have to do is add our bowl of vegetables.
I'm going to have to add more carrots.
In a few minutes. I'm going to give this another maybe 15 minutes and then, well, what the heck. I'll put it in 10 minutes and then I'll show you what it looks like.